Hello, my name is Steven Schroeder, captain of the Ursus Fight Club. For 29 years, I've been building armor and fighting in it. For the past 4 years, I've been fighting in Battle of Nations and IMCF tournaments internationally. During that time, I've been helping local fighters get into armor to join us on the field. Today, we have another new member that has brought the armor that he's recently received from Nadler Metalcrafts. He wants to make sure it is working for him and fits, and we can do any modifications that need to happen. Specifically, we're going to put in a chin strap in this helmet. We're going to install the chin strap that I recommend that all of our fighters use. This chin strap stops helmets from coming off during combat, and we've had many requests over the years to share this with other people, and now is a perfect opportunity to do that. So I hope you enjoy this tutorial. So here we have two helmets that have various liners and chin strap methods in them. This one, while I absolutely love this liner, this is the best liner by far that I have seen. In fact, having the tie downs for the Aventail. It also has the helm chin strap sewn into the liner. And while this might have some advantages, the challenge is that if the back of this helmet gets pulled, this helmet can come right off. Obviously, that is a problem for the type of combat that we're doing. This helmet, again, is fantastic, tempered metal. We've got the strap for the visor, we've got the Aventail already installed, and it comes with the liner, you know, sewn in, ready to go. Now there are two chin straps in here, two strapping systems. This one is designed to go around the throat to keep the helmet from rotating forward and hitting the face. The other strap is designed to sit underneath the chin and stop it from being able to be lifted off. What we're going to do is we're going to take both of those chin straps and combine it into one. To begin, we need to remove the Aventail and get access to the liner. These liners are stitched in, and in order to get access to the rivets and drilling the holes and do everything that we need to do, we're going to have to get those out of the way so we can get to what we need to work on. Now that that's removed, we can take this off, and you'll see that there is stitching underneath this that we need to get access to. So now that we've got access to it, I'm going to leave the stitching on the sides and the front. Getting these liners set properly is very important. I really don't want to have to mess with that more than once if I don't need to. So what we're going to do is we're going to start opening up just in the places necessary in order to get access to where we're going to install this chin strap. Currently, they have two rivets here and a Y-shaped chin strap. I love it, but we're going to install a D-ring that's going to have our chin strap that goes between those, make it easier to replace the chin strap and do the functionality that will be a great improvement on this piece. So right now we have the liner able to hang down, and we're going to be able to put that ship cleat in here and rest these rivets directly on here so I can center punch them, which will make it possible for me to drill them from the outside. So that trying to get that center punch as close to the middle of that rivet as possible. Now we're going to take it over to the drill press and drill these up. So we have this block of wood mounted to the table that we can set the helm over, which reduces the shaking vibration, making it easier to drill. So I was trying to leave the back stitched in, and it just came out on its own. When you stitch in your own liner, it's a really good idea to only do a couple of holes and then tie it off and then start another one. So that way if a thread cuts or is broken, everything doesn't unravel. So we've got the start done on those holes. I'm not gonna have to finish this off with a hand drill because it's been challenging on the drill press. At this point, you want to be careful not to go too far. You can drill through the rivet, and then the edge of the chuck can go and scratch the helmet itself. So I'm taking some care to make sure that doesn't happen. Well, that was tempered. We have most of the rivet drilled away. There's a little bit of mass here. However, we center punch this, it just goes right away. So I'm gonna need you to help me set the hole in the correct position on the helmet. Mm-hmm. When you clench your jaw, you have the muscle on your jaw you got that pulls out. Find that spot there. So we're gonna put the helmet on, and I'm gonna have you point to that spot. Just point to that. I'm also gonna double check that from the outside. Now the reason we're going for that spot there is when we put this D-ring here, the chin strap will be able to go underneath the throat here and to the chin there. If it was further back, it would be kind of restricting and choking. So this is the perfect spot for us to mount this. So go ahead and point to that spot that's right now right behind the ear. So at this point, we're going to go ahead and just mark right here and right there. When I take off this leather Aventail, I'm going to go ahead and move that mark in just a little bit to be closer to where we want it to be. Now, we're going to have this throw. It's going down under the chin, to the chin and then under the throat. We modified a little bit because the other line was going to be a little bit forward. And we already had existing holes in this liner, so this line should work as well. It's just not as optimal as we may like. It'll be fine. So this is the mark that I made that was just outside of the leather Aventail here. The mark that we wanted was going to be about right here. Now these vervels that are in here stick into about where that hole is. If I try drilling and riveting this D-ring in there, that's going to cause a problem. So what we're going to do instead is we're just going to come forward just a little bit of that original mark, and we're going to just have to go with this. You have to deal with whatever you have inside of the helmet and make it work as best you can. Don't try to make a mark with the center punch here. It's probably not going to make a very significant mark, but it'll help with the next step. So I'm going to center that up. Now, one thing that I'm doing with this that I've found helpful is I'm using my finger on the side of the helmet to hold that in place. So when I strike it, it doesn't jump off to the side. So drilling through a hardened steel helmet, usually a thicker material, is going to be somewhat challenging. You can do it with a brand new drill bit, slow speed, take your time, lots of pressure. They make some bits that are specialized for that. One of the things that you can do is that you can heat a rod till it's glowing and press it to this spot to try to anneal just this one point. I have a TIG welder. What I'm going to do is I'm just going to go ahead and TIG just this spot, try to heat it up, and that'll soften that area, making it easier for us to drill. So I'm going to go ahead and do that now. A little indentation where that happened. Hopefully We're going to drill this out with a small drill bit and then go for a larger one to enlarge the hole to the size we need. Goes nice and slow. If we hadn't have annealed that spot, that hole, depending on the metal that was used on, could have taken 5 or 6 different drill bits, normal drill bits. Now, one of the things that I was doing was holding my hand around the edge of the drill. That's so I can push down, give lots of pressure, but when it drills through, it's not going to go ahead and get scratched on the edge of the collar there. One thing I'm looking for when I'm drilling this is I want to make sure that there are significant size shavings of metal. If they're little tiny shavings, you're going too fast. So slow down a little bit. So when we attach these D-rings to the inside of the helmet, I want to have the pin the outside of this, and we're going to do a blind rivet, so it's going to be flush with the helmet and you're not going to see it when we're done. So we need to countersink the holes that I just drilled to give it some purchase when it's flush. The D-ring is now in there. It's facing the direction that I want it to end up. Rivet sticking out way too much more than we want. I'm just going to go ahead and clip this off. I'm putting the nippers flush with the helmet, which leaves a little bit of material up. And this isn't any rock, then we're just going to pound this until flat. At this point, we can buff that smooth and it'll just go away. Won't even notice it. So these are the D-rings that we're going to be installing. Now I just get these from Tandy Leather. Now that's just because it's nice and convenient. You could also make your own. Instead of doing a buckle, you could just make something, but you're never going to see that it's inside the helmet. And with this being nickel plated, it's not going to rust, not going to have any problems with it. It's done. So frequently when we install the D-rings, they're going to be at a slight misalignment. The easiest way to do this, to change the angle, is just to put something in here and then torque it to the direction you want it to be. So these were the existing holes in the padding. Now, if I was to do it myself, I would have done it in a slightly different location. We modified where this D-ring was going to try to take advantage and not do too many big holes in here. But what we're going to do is we're going to take a tape measure and we're going to feed it through this D-ring. I'm then going to go to the other side of the helmet and I'm going to feed the tape measure through that side as well. And what we're doing is we're trying to figure out what size chin strap, I mean, the dimensions in order to build it to fit him in this helmet. This is kind of a personalized fit. It's going to change based on everybody's size, and it doesn't take too long for you to make it yourself. But there's a little bit of help. So what we've got here is we've got the two ends of the tape measure sticking down from the helmet. I'm going to use that in order to take the measurements I need for Tim. The tape measure is run up into the D-ring, down, around, over to the other D-ring, and then back down. I'm going to place the tape measure, the beginning of the tape measure, on the side of the neck, because I don't like to have the buckle underneath the throat. So once I have that placed where I want it to be, I then go ahead and make sure the tape measure is taut on that side. And now I'm going to look at the sides of his chin here. This is the part that I want to split the chin strap so his chin will be able to set inside that chin cup nice and comfortably. So this one here looks like it's going to be about 2 1/4 inches in length, and we'll go ahead and test that before we finish cutting it. But that's what I'm going to mark down in my notes. Then I take the edge of the tape measure and I'm going to pull it back across until it's making contact with the initial part. And I note that measurement right now as 20 1/2 inches. Now I'm going to leave this hanging a little bit long, so the entire chin strap, the end of it's going to be down to about 26 inches when I'm said and done. I'm now going to transcribe those notes to my pattern and we'll get started making the chin strap. So, not to scale, but this is the general outline of the chin strap that we're going to do. When I took the measurements from the very end of the chin strap that was on the side of his left side of his throat, to the first side of the where his chin's going to be was 7 1/4 inches. From hole to hole is going to be 2 1/4. So the other hole is here to be 9 1/2. We're going to start out by cutting out a strip of leather out of latigo or something similar that's going to be 1 1/4 to 1 1/2 inches wide. We then punch these holes at these dimensions in. Then I'm going to cut out from hole to hole with the scissors. The holes help keep the leather from ripping any further past the point where we get it. We're going to make sure this is comfortable. Once we have the chin set and it's comfortable on him, we'll then by hand just trim in and then cut out about 1/4 inch of material on either side. So we're left with a strap that's about 3/4 inch wide. That may seem a little wide, but as it gets used and as it gets sweat and everything else, that's going to thin down and probably going to be closer to 1/2 inch. Now, the 21 1/2 was about where I thought that this buckle and the will be this leather strap will be buckling to the buckle. I leave it long so it hangs down and it's easier to undo. And I'll also go ahead and pop a hole in the end of this. So when you undo it or you're getting ready to put it on, you put this hole on the buckle so you don't ever have to try to fumble doing that from scratch while it's on your head. We're gonna take a hole punch and punch a hole in at both of those. Just in the center of the strap, nothing special. And hopefully we're done with this. I'm then gonna go ahead and cut this out. Now instead of cutting straight to the other side, I'm gonna cut a little football shape. I'm gonna make sure not to cut into the other side of the hole. Again, small increments. How does that feel? That looks like it'd be comfortable in there. Okay. So all we've done is, yeah, if you need to do a visual, whatever width this is, we're just taking that, curving it in so it doesn't get any thinner, and then we're just gonna create the strap. So I'm just gonna curve it in, cut it up, and then we've got that. Gonna go ahead and do it to the other side, and then we'll come back. So when I did the chin strap, I left both sides a little bit longer. They can always be trimmed back. I'm folding this expectation of where I'm gonna put the buckle. So I want this thing sitting about right here, so when the buckle is, when you buckle it, it's not going to be in the way of the throat. It's not gonna be digging in anywhere. So I've gone ahead in here, marking the center where that's gonna be. I'll now take it off, install the buckle. And now the tricky part of this is making sure when you put that buckle on there that a lot of times it's almost exactly the back reverse of what you expect it to be. So you're gonna make sure that the tongue is going to go away from us. So I'm just noting that when I'm doing this, I've got the suede side out of both sides. He wanted to have the smooth side of the chin strap out here. Personal preference, can work either way. But when it goes up and then down the D-ring, that means that it's the suede side that is being buckled together for the buckle. And we'll explain that here in just a second. So the chin strap is finished and we have it in the helmet. I want to show you how it's installed, how to modify it, and how to mark it, adjust it for the user, and give you some pointers on how to do it. So this is the chin strap inside the helmet. We had to nibble out the sides till it was comfortable on him. It's better to have to expand the chin strap cup than to start with it too big. So just do a little bit at a time until it fits comfortably on the chin. The chin strap gets passed through the D-ring, and when it's on you, will end up being doubled over like so, which is part of what helps this work so well. Notice on the other side, you've got the same thing going on. Can we see this? So we've got the D-ring, the strap passes through it, and it's going to double back. This part is going to end up getting tightened down under the chin. So we're going to go ahead and place this on his head. Notice I have a hole at the end of this long strap. We'll trim this down as necessary shortly, but right now it's long enough so that you can hold the chin strap with both thumbs as you're getting ready to put this on your head. That way the chin strap stays put out of the way and ready to be tightened. And now he's going to come and show us. He's going to place the chin cup on his chin, and he's going to pull down the sides to make sure it's even tension on both sides. Pull the chin strap down through the buckle. Go ahead and take the end, pull that strap down. And with that, we're going to go ahead and mark where that hole needs to be. Personally, I don't like to have more than one hole on my chin strap, if it's me. So I'm going to go ahead. Now this doesn't need to be super tight. The nice thing about this chin strap design is that it works in both directions. It works being pushed forward or lifting up. So I'm going to go ahead and punch that hole now. And we will end up oversizing this hole eventually. So there's one fairly big hole now that's going to be fairly easy to find and tighten. Now I'm going to cut off this strap so it's hanging down, not quite all the way below the oven tail here, but lift it up so it's going to be underneath. It's long enough to easily grab and manipulate. So at this point, when we put this visor down, let's go ahead and buckle this thing down the way it's going to be. The nice part about this design is that when you push forward, the helmet's not allowed to come forward, and this helmet can't be lifted off your head. You don't need to really cinch it down super tight in either direction, and the strap that goes over the D-ring and then back down ends up locking together so the strap itself doesn't slide or move. It's very comfortable and easy to do. Now, taking off the chin strap, I'm going to take this up so we can do it. Frequently what I do is I take my thumb and just pop the thumb off the chin strap off of my, and then you can go ahead and slide it off your head and you're done. You don't need to fiddle with the buckle at all at this point at all. Boom, we're done. So how was that?
Very easy and remarkably effective.
Was it a comfortable design?
Yeah, it was not coming off my head at all.
Compared to other chin straps, what have you
used? Yeah, I didn't have it swinging in my face, which was really nice.
Now, have other chin straps you've done been required to be tighter, or?
Yeah, some of the other chin straps I've had, you had to like really, yank it on your head, which is hard to talk or when you're fighting.
Well, this chin strap won't come off while you're steel fighting, so let's get you out to the field.
Thank you.